Good morning, students. Welcome to the biology class. Today we are starting with a new chapter, Heredity. In this chapter, we are actually starting with a new branch of biology, that is genetics. What is genetics? Genetics is the study of heredity and variation. It is the study of heredity and variation. Now, what is heredity? Heredity means the resemblance of parent to offspring, or the offspring to parent. The offspring resembles to the parent. So you can say the many genetic character passes from the parent to the offspring. This resemblance is known as the heredity. And what are variations? There are some differences in members of a species. For example, we all are human species, but we different human beings are friends. We differ from each other by some characters. These differences are known as variations. These differences are known as variations. The differences in the members of a same species are known as the variations. So, genetics is the study of heredity and variations. We will discuss in the chapter reproduction. We have studied that asexual reproduction gives some variation, while sexual reproduction gives many variations. Now, what is the basis for these variations? What is the mechanism? What are either any DNA, any cellular structure is responsible for it? So, we will study all that. We will give answer to all the questions. So, let us discuss the laws of matter. Mendel, John Mendel. Gregor John Mendel was an Austrian monk. He was an Austrian monk. He studied physical chemistry, biology, and the mathematics. He wanted to become a teacher, but he failed in the teaching eligibility examination. Then he moved toward the research side. He conducted experiments in the monastery. He conducted experiments on the Pisum spivum. That is garden pea plant. Sorry for interruption. So we were discussing that Mendel worked on the garden pea plant Pisum sativum. So what was the reason that Mendel chosen Pisum sativum for the garden pea plant? The thing is, first of all, pea plant is having contrasting pair of traits. What is a trait? Actually, traits are contrasting forms of a character. For example, stem height is a character, dwarfness and tallness form a trait. So, pea plant was having a number of contrasting pair of a trait. Seven characters, Mendel had chosen total seven characters or 14 traits. Another thing, Pisum sativum is an annual plant and it has a short lifespan. It is an annual plant having a short lifespan of 2 to 3 months. That is why the experimental data can be obtained. He will not have much have to wait for that. Experiment can be done easily and we can have the next generation after 2-3 months. That is why he chooses the pea plant. Pea plant is normally self seeds are large and he can see the variations easily. He can sow the seeds easily. Okay, so he chose the pea plant. Now, what exactly did Mendel had done? He cross pollinated two different traits, two plants having two different traits. This is the first cross of Mendel, known as the monohybrid cross. Mendel's monohybrid cross, very important topic. What is monohybrid cross? In which single character is taken at a time. In which single character is taken at a time, it means two traits we will be having. So what Mendel done? He took a tall plant. If you took a tall plant, it is one trait and another plant is dwarf. It is dwarf plant. And he cross-pollinated tall plants with a dwarf plant. He cross-pollinated tall with a dwarf plant. This is the parent generation P. He cross-pollinated tall plant and the dwarf plant. And the next generation came. The next generation, or you can say the first generation, this is parental generation, this is the first generation where offspring are formed. This generation is known as the F1 generation. F1 or the first filial generation. F1 generation or the first filial generation. F1 generation or the first filial generation. Where the term filial comes from the word, Latin word filus. It comes from Latin word. Comes from the Latin word filus. Filus means son or a offspring, father-offspring relationship. That is why it is known as the first filial generation, from the term filus. Okay, so in the first, what we observed in the first filial generation, that there was no dwarf plant, only tall plant was there. Means only one trait was expressed and one was not expressed. Now we done selfing of F1 generation, means now the F1 plants was allowed to self produce, reproduce within themselves. The F1 plants were allowed to reproduce within themselves. So we obtained the F2 generation, second filial generation. What we observe now, when in F1 generation there were no dwarf plants, but in the F2 dwarf plants reappeared. So in the F2, tall and dwarf plants. Tall and dwarf plants were obtained in the ratio of 3:1. They were obtained in the ratio of 3:1. So dwarf plants were there, but their population, their ratio was less. So repeating, in the parental generation, he took a tall plant, he took tall plants and dwarf plants. He crossbred tall plants with the dwarf plants. So we obtained the F1 first filial generation. In the F1 generation, we were having only the tall plants, no dwarf plant was observed. Then he allowed them to reproduce within themselves. What he done, that these F1 plants were allowed to reproduce within themselves. So we obtained the F2 generation. In the F2 generation, the dwarf plants reappeared and the tall and dwarf plants appeared in the ratio of 3:1. Now we